my new regime of self-enforced, deliberate practice. Here was my first lesson. This type of skill development is hard. When I got to the first tricky gap in the paper's main proof argument, I faced immediate internal resistance. It was as if my mind realized the effort I was about to ask it to expend, and in response, it unleashed a wave of neuronal protest, distant at first, but then, as I persisted, increasingly tremendous, crashing over my concentration with mounting intensity. To combat this resistance, I deployed two types of structure. The first type was time structure. "I am going to work on this for 1 hour," I would tell myself. "I don't care if I faint from the effort or make no progress. For the next hour, this is my whole world." But of course I wouldn't faint, and eventually I would make progress. It took on average 10 minutes for the waves of resistance to die down. Those 10 minutes were always difficult, but knowing that my efforts had a time limit helped ensure that the difficulty was manageable. The second type of structure I deployed was information structure, a way of capturing the results of my hard focus in a useful form. I started by building a proof map that captured the dependencies between the different pieces of the proof. This was hard, but not too hard, and it got me warmed up in my efforts to understand the result. I then advanced from the maps to short, self-administered quizzes that forced me to memorize the key definitions the proof used. Again, this was a relatively easy task, but it still took concentration, and the result was an understanding that was crucial for parsing the detailed math that came next. After these first two steps, emboldened by my initial successes in deploying hard focus, I moved on to the big guns, proof summaries. This is where I forced myself to take each lemma and walk through each step of its proofs, filling in missing steps. I would conclude by writing a detailed summary in my own words. This was staggeringly demanding, but the fact that I had already spent time on easier tasks in the paper built up enough momentum to help push me forward. I returned to this paper regularly over a period of 2 weeks. When I was done, I had probably experienced 15 hours total of deliberate practice-style strain, but due to its intensity, it felt like much more. Fortunately, this effort led to immediate benefits. Among other things, it allowed me to understand whole swaths of related work that had previously been mysterious.